Now, with regards to herd immunity, we have some kind of new studies that have come out indicating that this coronavirus, like other coronaviruses, those viruses that cause the common cold, tend to behave the same way. And that is that, you know, we have some viruses where you get it once in your life and you have immunity forever. You're never going to get that virus again. You have other viruses, something like HIV, that you may get and probably will have forever and be able to keep that under control with medications. The coronavirus people get, they develop some brief immunity, the ability to fight that virus off, but unfortunately, that immunity doesn't stay around, and that's why we keep getting the common cold over and over again. And that's what these recent studies have indicated, is that even individuals that do develop immunity, develop antibodies, unfortunately those antibodies in many cases are disappearing very quickly. So the concern there is that it doesn't matter how many people we expose, we are not going to probably develop herd immunity, and unfortunately we may just end up with a lot more individuals that have severe consequences or die from this.
I would just add again, I'm not a physician. I take my orders from a physician. But, you know, Steve, when you talk about herd immunity or banking on a vaccine, that doesn't account for between now and then. And then is way off in the distance. And as the Fairbanks study showed us, if we're at 3% that have had or have it currently, we're talking about 97% who haven't yet.
That's right.
And it's still an infectious virus rolling around the hills out there. And so we have to focus on controlling what we can. And that's our own behavior. That's how we slow the spread, so that all of a sudden you're not looking at a positivity rate of 14 or 50 or what we're seeing in some other places around the country. So it's just critically important that we don't hope for a vaccine. I'm hoping for it, but just that's not the strategy. And that's our hope for sure, but or herd immunity is so far off. You know, talk about 70, 80, 90%. That's way
even down. Those county or those countries that have tried it, like Sweden and the UK to some extent, have really not been successful. When they have looked back, they've seen maybe 7% of their population in prevalence studies that are immune, so or have any antibodies. I wouldn't even call it immune. And that's why we've been so careful when people have asked us about antibody testing. Is it just because you have antibodies? We don't know that that keeps you from getting infected again.
Yeah, and sometimes you're, you know, it like you just said, it comes back in 4 months, or sometimes you remain positive for 45 straight days. So, I mean, the overlap here is the focus has got to be control. We got to manage our way through this, and we got to make sure our healthcare system is not overwhelmed so we can care for those folks who are positive, who go into the emergency room and then are hospitalized and into the ICU beds.
That's right.
That whole process.